A Redwood application is designed to provide a comprehensive set of features to meet a wide range of business requirements. For example, managing a user's passport information. In addition, you can make changes to your application to best fit your specific business needs. For example, show or hide fields, make them read-only or required, or even show or hide entire regions of a page. You implement all of these modifications using business rules in Visual Builder Studio and Express Mode. This video teaches you how. We start signed in as a user with the application administrator role, giving us access to Visual Builder Studio. First, we navigate to the page we want to modify. In our example, we'll modify the identification info page. In the passport section, we've been asked to make the issuing location field read-only, hide the profession field, and make the expiration date field required. Finally, since our company doesn't use it, we need to hide the driver's license region. We've been asked to ensure that these changes only apply when users are viewing their own records. Use the Settings and Actions menu to start Visual Builder Studio. If it's your first time using it, you may be asked to create a project. For this demonstration, I already have one prepared. Now that you've started VB Studio, verify that you're in Express mode. To change the display properties of fields or regions, you need to adjust your business rules. Click Configure Fields and Regions to navigate to the Rule Editor. Notice that Oracle already provides you with a large number of built-in rules that determine default behavior. If one of these existing rules is similar to your business requirements, you can duplicate it and modify the copy to save time. For our quick proof of concept, we'll create a new rule that overrides that behavior. The great thing about business rules is that the override will only apply to the fields you modify. All other fields will continue to have their default behavior. Add a rule and give it a descriptive name. A description of exactly what you're doing is also helpful. First, we'll set the conditions. By default, you can specify the roles, countries, and viewing conditions for which the rule applies. You can add additional conditions based on field values on the page, user information, or use advanced expressions using the Expression Builder, or even some limited JavaScript. Some pages even support using initial values as conditions. For our requirement, we set viewing own info as our only condition. Now it's time to make our modifications. To find an element, you can either search for it manually or use the convenient filter box at the top of the page. For available elements, you may be able to set them to be required, hidden, or read-only, or default a field value using the value property. The available settings depend on the element. In our case, we set it to read-only. This will override the default settings for that element. You can review information about your override in the default settings, or remove the override to restore the default. We'll do the same thing for the other elements, but we'll do it more quickly because the settings are similar. Once you're done, you can select the checkbox to verify that you've only changed the elements you intended to, and you've changed all of them. It's time to preview your results. You can either maximize the preview panel and review your results there, or use the preview button to preview the application in a separate browser tab. In a real test, you would also preview the results by reviewing another person's identification info page, for example, as an administrator, but we won't do that for time's sake. Once your testing is complete, publish your changes and you're done. You've used a business rule to modify field and region properties using VB Studio and Express Mode. Thanks for watching!